I present you the setup 2016.
Want to be a pro? Check out Battlefy, an esports website where you can join and create hundreds of free or paid tournaments every month. Link in the description.
What's going on, guys? It's Corzix, and today I'm coming at you guys with my 2016 setup video that I promised you guys I would put out at 10,000 subscribers. Now, this is my new updated setup from this last past year, and I've made some serious upgrades. I've built an entire computer, and I've bought new monitors, and I've done a lot of things, so I'm going to go ahead and get into the whole setup, and we're going to save the PC for last. It's a cheap, affordable PC build. It cost me around $850 for all the pieces in it, and it runs just about everything at max settings, so I will get into that at the very end and get into very specifics on that. I'll take it up and take it apart and show you everything that's inside of it. Alright, so just a quick overview, guys. We have a 3-2-3 monitor setup, and these monitors are actually awesome. This LG monitor, I actually don't remember the model of this LG model right here, but I've had this monitor for such a long time. Like, it's been, like, literally I've had this for probably 5 years, and I bought it from like Best Buy a while back. So this probably isn't a monitor that you guys want to have, but these two right here, this BenQ, they're both the same monitor. I bought two of them because they're on sale. They're still on sale on Amazon at the time. They're awesome. They have 1 millisecond refresh rate, which is insane. They're 60 hertz each. Beautiful, beautiful monitors. They capture so much color. And if you guys are really into like competitive gaming or anything like that, these monitors right here will get everything for you. Like, they are beautiful monitors. This one is actually hooked up to my Xbox, and this one is hooked up to my PC. And I have the dual monitor set up right here for the PC as well as the Xbox right here. So these BenQs, everything, by the way, everything in this description right here will be, or everything in this setup will be in the description below, including the links to the on sale versions on Amazon, so you guys can see these BenQs. I personally love BenQ because they're MLG sponsored and they're beautiful monitors. They work so well. I've had no complaints with this monitor. It's such a good monitor. It runs everything beautifully. Everything just looks so good on it. All right, so on top of the three things we have up top, we also down low have my Xbox One hooked up. It's a little messy. I've got that hooked up to my Elgato, which hooks into my PC right here. And I've also got that hooked up to my mix amp for my Astro A40s. Now, I had my A40s in my last setup video because I haven't got rid of them because they're just such a nice headset. I recommend the A40s over the A50s if you're planning on doing anything PC related to your build, because these hook up USB to your PC as well as to your Xbox at the same time through this mix amp. The A50s don't do that. So you don't want to have A50s if you are doing Xbox and PC at the same time. So I don't have to like transfer audios over. If I turn on my Xbox, I can hear my Xbox as well as hear everything that's going on my PC. So it's really badass. A40s are a must have. I love this headset. It's so comfortable. Beautiful headset, honestly, and it's like adjustable completely. It has no cracks on it. I've had these for like a year and a half. No cracks, no nothing. And I usually am pretty rough with my headphones, so this is freaking sweet. And it comes with the mix amp, which has like all the controls all over it and everything. Beautiful, beautiful headset. Oh, and I also have my Kinect right here. Forgot to mention that. Sorry, Kinect, I don't ever use you. All right, so I record all of my audio still from my Blue Yeti microphone right here. I love this thing. It's got a little pop guard on the front of it, but this microphone has been amazing, and the customer support over at Blue Microphones is absolutely awesome. They're spectacular. My first one had a faulty USB port, and I sent it back to them, and they said they couldn't find any problems with it before finally I was like, guys, I swear there's a problem with it, and they just were like, okay, fine. So they just sent me a new one completely, like, all right, there, and they didn't have to need any proof or anything. So that was really awesome of them. They're really great. It has three different tones on it. Let me turn this around, I'll show it to you. It's got three different settings on it. You've got back and forth setting, which literally just does the front and the back of the microphone, and then the full circle, which captures full area, the front only setting, which is what I have on right now, and the singing setting, which takes a lot from the front and a little bit from the back because it picks up vocals better or something. So I'm not really sure how that works, but I only use the front for my audio because it's honestly the best setting for it. Okay, so for my streaming settings and everything, I use this Logitech webcam right here. I got it off of Amazon, and it's a nice little webcam. It's $40, I believe, on Amazon is how much I got it for, and it records at 720 in HD. So it's not a 1080p one, but they don't really make very many 1080p's that are that cheap, or 720p's that are that cheap, for instance. So a lot of people like the other one. I don't remember what it's called, but It's a very common one. It's about $80, but I had that for a little while. Didn't really like it. Saw no difference between this and that. So I honestly just went with this. I think it's a really good little webcam to have. All right, so before I whip out the PC, let me show you guys just the little peripherals that come with it. This actually, neither one of these came with the PC itself. This is from Hypercooler, and they're a company that makes usually like fans and cooling systems and things like that. But they also had this keyboard option, which is this. Honestly, this keyboard is beautiful. Like, I'll let you guys hear real quick. It makes good clicking sounds and everything. Great keyboard. Plus, you've got a wide variety of colors you can choose from on your undercooler or in your underlights. And it was a keyboard mouse combo, and it also came with the nice mouse. They had a cheaper version. This one was $60, and they had a cheaper version for $40, but it came with a mouse that wasn't as good. It didn't have any side buttons on it or anything. Like, this one has side buttons, and it also has the nicer bottom to it, which is smoother and slicker, and it clicks very fast. It's a great mouse if you're into like League of Legends or anything like that. It's a beautiful mouse. It feels really comfortable, and it also has color changing options on it, which is really cool. It's about $60. Awesome brand, never breaks it. They're great. I honestly love them. And then I got my Galaxy mouse pad because I'm into everything Galaxy. Alrighty guys, so here's the behemoth. Beautiful, 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 beautiful machine right here. I love it so much. It took me a very, very long time to build and put together. I'm gonna go ahead and take this panel off and show you guys the inside, but first let me tell you about the PC itself. The whole build was about $900 total, and it's got everything you really need in it for really high performance gaming or editing or rendering or anything like that. It's a really great PC, honestly. Let me start with the tower itself. This is a Thermaltake tower. The link will be in the description down below, along with every single piece of the part or every single piece of this computer that's in here. Let me go ahead and open up this back panel real quick and show you guys the inside. Okay, so it's currently on at the moment, and I don't want to shock anything, so I'm not going to be poking anything directly, but I guess I'll go ahead and start from top to bottom and show you guys everything that's important about it. As you can see, everything fits in there nicely with your cord management and everything. It's a really great setup, honestly, with this tower, because it's a very good-sized tower, very good tower. It's not a DIY tower, one of those crappy, like, cheap ones. Had all the room for everything that I needed in it. I had to make no adjustments at all. It was really good, and it also came with two fans on the inside, one over here and one behind. Over here where your disk drive would go, but I don't have a disk drive, so let's start from the bottom. First off, we have a CX 600 watt power supply, which was a great power supply. It was very cheap, about $40 from Corsair, and Corsair makes awesome products. I love their products. Very high quality. This thing had no problems whatsoever. My buddy actually bought a cheaper Stillwell brand, and it blew on him like literally the second he hooked it up. So I had no problems with this one. It was really good. I really enjoy it. And then we have our memory right here. I have a 1 gig card and a 1 terabyte card, 2 terabyte card. I do not have a solid state drive in here. Didn't really think I needed one. You can get one if you'd like. It really just, like, if you download Windows onto it, it'll make your PC start up faster and any games you want to start faster or anything like that. I didn't really care. I can wait on a little bit of a loading time. It's literally like $300 for a 2 second difference. I'm not really into it that much. So yeah, we have our 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte drives in here. And then as we go up, we have an MSI, All right, this is an MSI Gaming Z97 or Gaming 5 LGA. It is a beautiful motherboard. It had every single hookup I needed with plenty of space everywhere. Plus, MSI is a very good gaming brand. They make some great stuff. It's honestly really pretty at the same time. It matches the whole color scheme that's going on the inside of this, which looks pretty good. And then on my RAM side, which is right here, this is my RAM. I have 4 Ripjaw 4 gig sticks. So I have 16 gigs of RAM in there. You can go up to as much as you want. It's not really hard to get more RAM. It's not expensive. You could go without maybe you want. 16 works for me perfectly fine, and I do all of my rendering and editing without any delays at all. So 16 honestly would work for you unless you're going absolutely crazy with your build. My processor that's hooked up to that, you can't see the processor itself, but it's behind that fan right there. That is a Intel i7 Devil's Canyon quad core 4 gigahertz processor. Very, very beefy processor. I mainly got it for editing and rendering purposes, but you don't have to get a processor that's that expensive if you're not doing hardcore heavy rendering or editing. It's a very beefy processor, cost me a lot of money. It was about $350, and it was the most expensive part of the entire build. So you don't have to get anything that big, but if you really want this setup right here, which is great for rendering and editing, I would recommend that processor. I've had no problems with it, and everything is so fast. It's a great processor. 4 gigahertz is a lot to get out of it. Then as we go down to the last and most beautiful piece, I would say, is our graphics card. This is an EVGA GeForce GTX 950. Great graphics card. You can go a little bit more with the 960, or you can go a lot more with the 970. There's a lot of different options you can do with graphics cards. I use a 950, and it's honestly an amazing card. It works perfectly. I can run most games at max frames. I know I can run Arma 3 at max settings at 120 frames a second. So every game really plays super well through this. I've had literally no lag issues or anything, like frame drop or anything like that with anything that goes on in here. This is a beautiful, beautiful graphic card or GPU. And it also has a fan on it as well, at like a personal fan for it, as well as 2 gigs of dedicated RAM to it itself. And I've had no complaints. Like I said, it's a beautiful, beautiful card. Alrighty guys, so that's the full setup. I really hope you guys enjoyed this setup video for 10K subs. And I really hope that this helped you out if you guys want to start your own gaming rig yourself. Like I said, it was easy to build, but it took a very long time. It took me about 6 hours. I'd never built a computer before. So it took, like I said, it took a very long time, but I had to look up tutorials and everything. If I were to do it again, it would take me no time at all. So it's a great build. I really recommend it. Beautiful computer, as well as monitors and such. So if you guys want to start a YouTube channel, I recommend everything that's right here. If you guys are just into some really heavy gaming, I recommend that, and that. Beautiful things right here. So everything will be in the description down below. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to leave a big fat like on the video, as well as subscribe to me for more awesome content just like this. And until next time, this is Corzix, and I'm out. See you guys.
Whatever gets the W.
How did you grow so fast?
I bought 10,000 subscribers.
Just playing.
I kept my videos consistent, funny, and I had fun with it.
Is that a good answer?
That's probably a pretty good answer.
What sports did you practice growing up?
Well, I played literally every single sport when I was younger. I played soccer the most. Soccer was the most...